Hey guys, welcome to second part of Excel filters. In this video we will discuss and we will cover complete advanced filters in Microsoft Excel. Friends, if you still have not been subscribed to our channel, I will request you to please subscribe it now and press bell icon button so that you don't miss any new coming tutorial on this channel. So now let's move toward our tutorial. Here we have a table that we will use in this tutorial. Before starting this tutorial, let's have some idea what this table is all about. Here in this column of table, we have different types of items including t-shirts, dress pants and jeans pants of different colors. Next column contains dates on which we have been purchased these items. And then we have here status of this inventory or this item that shows that either this inventory or these items are finished or not finished. Then here we have price per unit for these items. And at last we have current location of this inventory or these items that either these items are in our shop or in our storeroom or these are finished. Now let's move toward advanced filters. For advanced filters, we need minimum two things. The first and obvious thing for advanced filter is source data. Source data means the data or table on which we will apply advanced filter. For this tutorial, this table is our source data because we will apply advanced filter on this and we will try to filter this data or this table using advanced filters. The second thing for advanced filters that we need is criteria range. Criteria range mean the base on which we will try to filter our source data. Suppose as this is our source data and suppose I'm interested here to filter this table based on the items that have status finished. So here our criteria range is finished. So if I want to separate or if I want to take separate my criteria range from this table, I will just copy this status paste here and I will also copy this finished and I will paste here. So now this is our source data and this is our criteria range. These are two things that we need. These are two minimum things that we need to use advanced filters. So now let's use advanced filters. To use advanced filters, we need to go in data tab. In data tab, we have here filter and advanced filters. We will go for advanced filters. And here you can see we need to provide minimum two types of range here. The first list range is same as we set our source data, so we will select our source data. The second thing here, criteria range. So as this is our criteria range, so we will select this. Here above you can see we have here two options. First option, filter the list in place. This means do we want to filter this list or this data on its place, or second option, copy to another location. This means or do we want to copy our filtered data on another location. For now, I will just let this option be as it is. I suppose I'm just interested to filter my source data or this list on its place. So I will go for OK. And here you can see this was our criteria range, means we want to filter this data based on this criteria. So here you can see the advanced filter has filtered this data based on status finished. Here you can see these all items are those that are finished. So now I will clear this filter and now we will try another option or another criteria. Maybe I will just use criteria from here, item name. I will just paste it here and here I just want t-shirt yellow. I will copy and I will paste it here. Again I will go for advanced filter. Again I will select, I think this is already selected here, and this is criteria range. I will select here and I will go for OK. And here you can see now advanced filter has filtered this source data based on this criteria, that is t-shirt yellow. So again I will go, I will clear this filter. This was same as it is. This is t-shirt yellow. This same word we can find here, t-shirt yellow. Before we used finished word finished here, we can use word finished here same as it is. But suppose here I just want to search for shirt. Here you can see we have shirt, t-shirt, yellow, dress shirt, black and so on. We have different types of shirts with different colors. But suppose if I want to just search for shirt, what I will do, if I write here shirt and again I go to advanced filters and this is my criteria range and I will go for OK, you will see this will show me no result. Here you can see this is showing me no result. Just let me clear this. This is why, because this shirt is not, no word here is starting with this word shirt. So if this word shirt is in between the words, here you can see t-shirt yellow means shirt is in between t and yellow. Here dress shirt yellow, shirt is between dress and black, these words. So what I will do, I will insert here static at start and static at last. Now it is this criteria range shows that I want to filter this data based on any cell that has word shared in between other words. So what I will do, I will again go to advanced filters. Again, this our source data is selected, our criteria range is this, and I will go for OK. And here you can see this has been filtered all items that have shared, all cells that have shared in it. Till now we have discussed advanced filters with criteria range that has text in it. Now let's use another criteria that has number in it. What I will do, I will just delete this criteria range. I will also clear this filter, and now maybe I will just copy it and paste it here, and now I will use this criteria range, and I want to filter this source data based on this criteria range. Means any cell equal to 220, I want to filter that cell. So I will go for advanced filters and I will go for OK, and here you can see all cells equal to 220 are filtered here. So now suppose if I want to filter here all cells that are that have value less than 220, what I will do, I will just insert here sign less than, and I will just again I will clear here filter, and I will again go to advanced filters, and this is already criteria range and source data is already selected. I will go for OK, and here you can see this source data is filtered based on this criteria. Means this number, any number that is less than 220 is filtered here, and you can see. And now what I will do, if I want to, I just let me clear this again. If I want to filter any value that is greater than 220, what I will do, I will just insert here sign greater than. Again, I will go to advanced filters. I will go for OK, and here you can see all values greater than 220 are filtered here. Now suppose I want to filter values that are not equal to 220. What I will do, I will insert here sign not equal to, smaller than, greater than, these both signs when come together, that means not equal to. So I will again clear this filter from here. I will go again advanced filters, this source data, and this criteria is selected already. I will go for OK, and here you can see we don't have any value that is 220, or we can say we have here all values other than 220. Now suppose that I want to use two criteria at same time. Till now we have discussed just one criteria at a time, that was equal to, greater than, smaller than, not equal to. But now maybe I want to use two criteria, that may be any value that is greater than 100 and maybe smaller than 220, I want to filter that values. So what I will do, I will write here first criteria, that is greater than 100, and here I will write second criteria, smaller than 220, and here I will also copy and paste here header. Just let me delete this and let me also clear this filter. Now let's go to advanced filter again, and this you can see this our source data is selected already. Just we need to change our criteria range. Here you can see we have been selected these our both criteria ranges. So I will go for OK. Here you can see we have values that are greater than 100 but smaller than 220. So these are use of two criteria range at same time. Now suppose that I want to use three criteria range at same time. Till now we have discussed just text at a time and just numbers at one time, but now we will use text and number both at same time. So just I will clear this filter, and maybe I will just copy it item name here, and maybe I want t-shirt. So now we have three criteria. First is t-shirt, second is value should be greater than 100 but should not be greater than 220 or should be less than 220. So again I will go to advanced filters, and this our source data is selected already. We will change our criteria range, and now we will select all these three criteria range, and I will go for OK. Here you can see these are all t-shirts, but value is not less than 100 and not greater than 220. Now I will clear this filter, and again I will go to advanced filter. Here the thing that I want to show you is that our working up to now with advanced filter was based on this first option, filter the list in place. That means we were using the same place of our source data for filtering purposes. Here we can use second option also. That means by this option we can copy our filtered data to another location. Okay, let's try this now. You can see here our source data is selected already. Our criteria range is this. So now here we need to here you can see third option is also activated. Now here we need to select the cell number on which we want to copy our filtered data. Maybe I want to copy here my filtered data and I will go for OK. And here you can see now filtered data is copied to this location. Now one more thing, I will again go to advanced filter, and here you can see here unique records only. I will select this second option, copy to another location, and unique records only. By this unique records only, I can extract unique values from my source data. Maybe here suppose I'm interested to extract unique values from this column. Here you can see t-shirt yellow, and same like this, these items are repeated many times. If I want to extract unique values or unique item names from this column, how I can do this using advanced filter. So here I will select list range because I want to just extract unique values from just this column. I will select this column, and criteria range I will just remove it because there is no criteria, and here cell in which I want to copy unique values. Here I want to copy unique values box is checked, so I will go for OK, and here you can see these are unique values only. Now friends, let's review our performance, what we have been learned up to now regarding advanced filters. Here you can see if we apply advanced filter on numbers equal to, less than, greater than, not equal to, greater than, and less than, we have been discussed everything up to now regarding these numbers. Then regarding text, equal to and includes, we have been discussed all that. Includes, maybe you don't understand, just rewind this thing, that when we have been inserted here static, and then we inserted right here shirt, and then static, that means shirt, any text that includes shirt should be filtered. And then other items, two or more than two criteria for filtering. Here you can see we have more than two criteria for filtering. And then at last, copy filtered data to another location. We have been already discussed this, copy filtered data to another location. And then at last, unique values from data. This is unique values from data. And then at last, limitations of basic filters and plus points of advanced filters. As we have been already discussed basic filters, and we have been already covered this complete topic in our first tutorial of Excel filters, so we know that basic filters are also very usable, but there are some limitations of basic filters. Because of those limitations, we use advanced filters. So now let's discuss what are those limitations. First limitation of basic filter is that we cannot copy filtered data to another location directly. Just let me show you. I will apply here now basic filter, and now suppose I want to copy data, filtered data based on these finished goods. What I will do, I will filter this data based on finished goods, and then I will just copy it, and then I will paste to another location. We cannot directly copy to another location this filtered data, same as we did in advanced filters. We cannot do this in basic filters, therefore we use advanced filters. The second limitation is that we don't know filter criteria. Here you can see, here we have been used advanced filters. This is our filter criteria. But in our basic filter, basic filtering, we don't know what is our filter criteria. Here you can see we don't know what is our filter criteria. When we will go here to this filter sign, here you can see this is showing us this our filter criteria is finished. So we cannot directly know what is our filter criteria whenever we will be using basic filters. So this is limitation of basic filters. So these are plus points. These limitations of basic filters are plus points of advanced filters. Here is one more thing, one extra plus point of advanced filter is that we can extract unique values using advanced filters. And here this is also, we can use more than one criteria at same time. Here you can see if I have been used here one criteria finished, maybe then I want another criteria. I want maybe shirt. I want to filter based on shirt. So this is second criteria. First I need to use first criteria, then second, then maybe third or fourth. But here in advanced filters, we can directly use maybe 2, 3, 4, 5 or whatever number of filters we want to use. We can directly use all these filters at the same time. So friends, that's all. If you like this video, please don't forget to give thumbs up. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel and press bell icon button. Also share this knowledge with your friends. And if you don't understand anything, just mention in below comment section. I will answer all of your questions. And at last, thanks for watching. Bye bye.